Hi, my name is Violeta Georgieva and I work in regulatory affairs with EuropaBio. I like my job because it has to do with innovation. I'm very passionate about innovation and I want to show to people that innovation happens in Europe and we should really make sure that we foster innovation and create the right incentives to keep innovation in Europe and to keep our very bright and excellent scientists also in Europe. Scientists in the plant breeding area, they're constantly looking for new characteristics which could be potentially useful for the better performance of the plants in different areas. So for example, if there is a disease or if there is a pest and certain group of plants are affected by that disease and that disease is killing them, the scientists in Europe will be interested to make the plant resistant and so basically to save the plants from a certain pest. So they start screening and then looking for a source where they can get a resistant gene so that they can basically also make the plant resistant and save it from the pests. Whenever they find these characteristics, so they start to develop a product. And the development of such a product as the ones that we deal with on a daily basis takes on average 13 years, so from the screening process until putting that product on the market. So it's a very lengthy process and it requires a lot of time and also resources, obviously. So whenever they develop such a characteristic and they want to commercialize it, they need to first apply for approval to put that product on the EU market. So they first file an application and that application goes to the European Food Safety Authority. And then the scientists in the European Food Safety Authorities, they basically do a similar thing to what the company's researchers have already done. So basically they look at the safety of the characteristics of this newly found characteristic. And so they assess it from different angles just to make sure that it's safe enough to be put in our food chain. It's a number of studies that they need to conduct to confirm the safety of the plant. So they look at the molecular characterization, for example. They look at the environmental risk assessment, because what they need to assess is actually whether that characteristic is as safe as any other similar plant that we know. And they also need to check whether there could be any risk for humans, for animals, and for the environment as well. I believe that we should all trust the science which is being done in Europe because we have many different actors involved in the whole safety confirmation process. We have the scientists employed by the companies, we have scientists employed by research institutions which are public, and we also have the scientists who work for the European Food Safety Authority. So basically they come from different backgrounds and they are also paid by different people. But the good thing is that they all tell us that the technology that is being developed in Europe and elsewhere, so genetically engineered plants, they're safe, as the conventionals.